Brothers and sisters, praise the Lord. He is so good. He is so merciful. He's so righteous. So I was thinking, how can I explain to the people that are in condemnation, they're in bondage, they think you have to have works and be so holy and righteous to get into heaven and to be saved. And this precious sister, Bonnie Lutube, who was preaching the same repentance message as me before I got the revelation of grace, popped up and the Holy Spirit said, see, watch, see, watch. And so I was busy at the time, and then I watched it and I was like, praise the Lord, another confirmation. She explains everything in a way that I just did not have time to explain it. And I just want you to please watch it because it is truth, truth. There's a couple things, you know, about repentance and what it actually translates in Greek. But for the most part, the Lord is doing a mighty work on her. He has done a mighty work. He's doing a mighty work in me. He's doing a mighty work in other people. And I just want you to watch this, okay? So.
The title's true. I was deceived by Lordship salvation, and because I was deceived, I was deceiving others on my channel, on Facebook, and I have to apologize from the bottom of my heart. And all of this explains why I've had such a hard time just worshiping, you know, because I was so confused. I didn't understand the truth. I didn't understand the true gospel, and I'm ashamed, and I fought it. I fought this with a lot of people. You know, I had people coming at me in all directions saying that I didn't have it right. And I was like, what are you talking about? Paul Washer's amazing. Like, how can you say that about Paul Washer? He's definitely being used by the Lord. And I do believe that he's being used by the Lord in certain ways. But I don't believe that he has it right. I think he says things that sound good, sound biblical, sound true. But just because something sounds biblical doesn't mean it's biblical. It doesn't mean it's true. And in my efforts to defend Lordship salvation, I found the alternate belief, which they call easy believism. And when I read it, I thought it was ridiculous. And now I feel horrible saying that. Because easy believism is the true gospel. And they give it this name that sounds like we're a bunch of lazy, you know, people that want to have a license to sin. But that's not it. That's not it. Yes, we are allowed to make mistakes. If you want to call that a license to sin, go right ahead. But it really is grace. It's grace that allows us to be imperfect and rely on the perfection of Jesus Christ. Rely on the finished work on the cross, okay? He took all of our punishment. He became sin so we could become righteousness. So we could put on the righteousness of God. And I know there are a lot of people out there defending Lordship salvation, bringing up that scripture about the people that were denied heaven because they were workers of iniquity. Well, what about them was so unique? They relied on their works to enter heaven, not the grace of God, not the finished work on the cross. They never knew Jesus. They never knew the truth. Jesus told them, I never knew you. Depart from me, workers of iniquity. And the reason that they were seen as workers of iniquity is because they didn't have the righteousness of Christ, because they didn't believe that he took their sin. Do you see what I mean? When God looks at someone who relies on Jesus Christ's sacrifice to enter heaven, he sees his son. He doesn't see us anymore. Jesus literally takes our place. The Holy Spirit comes into us and lives for us. It's Christ in us, not us anymore. It's like the scripture, I no longer live, but Christ lives in me. Well, God sees his son in us. But when he looks at people who do not rely on the sacrifice of Jesus Christ for eternal life, he sees sin because they don't have faith. They don't have all of their faith in the finished work of Christ on the cross. They don't have that. They don't believe the gospel. They think that they have to have works too. But when Jesus died on the cross, he said, "It is finished." So anything that you add to that, anything you add to Jesus, what Jesus did, is wrong. The Bible says, do not add or take away. And these people think that we're taking away from the gospel. And they condemn us for taking away from the gospel. But we're not. We're not taking away. It's just that simple. All we have to do is believe. Put our trust in the Lord. That's all. That's what repentance is turning from whatever you're trusting in to trusting in Christ. That's what real repentance is. And they're saying that you have to repent from your sins to be saved. But that's like saying that you have to become well before you go to the doctor. That doesn't make any sense. Yes, we should repent from our sins. We should turn away from our sins, but that's not what saves us. What saves us is Jesus Christ. What saves us is relying on the fact that Jesus died on the cross for our sins. He took our sins so we can become righteousness. That's what saves us. Then the Holy Spirit comes in and makes sin undesirable as life goes on. Repentance from sin is a process that takes years and years, and it's not what saves us. Salvation is not a lifelong process. It's not like you try to be saved every day and you hope that you're saved, by the time you die. No, you're saved when you believe on Jesus. The moment that you believe on Jesus, you are saved. And then repentance happens every day. We work every day to please God, not to be saved, but because we should want to please our Father, because the Holy Spirit is in us, and the Holy Spirit's working in us. And those who believe on Jesus but have not had that big transformation yet, that's probably just because they haven't been seeking God. And that doesn't mean that they're not a child of God, okay? God has all the different types of children. Some are obedient and some are not. And that doesn't make him any less of their father. He is still their father. See, it's not about us. It's not about our righteousness. It's about God's righteousness. And this is why I dealt with so much pride. And that's why a lot of people who are out there preaching Lordship salvation have this pride issue, because they have this self-righteousness. And that's just as bad as unbelief. Thinking that you can enter heaven because of yourself. That's not the way it works. It's all about God's righteousness, not us. The only way we get into heaven is through his righteousness. And if you look at every single scripture that talks about being saved, it's always like those who believe. John 3:16, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. Okay, this is why someone who's dying in the hospital or dying in a car accident scene, like, you can go up to them and say, do you accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior who died on the cross for your sins? They can say yes, and they can go to heaven. Well, what about their works? They didn't have works. They don't need works to get into heaven. They need faith. We're saved by grace through faith. Faith. That's all. The moment you have faith in Jesus and his sacrifice, you are sealed. You're sealed, and the Lord will bring you along for the ride. You know, he will be not your co-pilot, but your driver. See, that's the thing. When you believe that you have to have Jesus and yourself, you think, well, Jesus is like the co-pilot. No. Jesus is the driver. You're along for the ride. He's taken over at that point. All you need is to have faith in him, and that's also a gift. No one comes to the Son unless the Father draws them. So a lot of people are drawn to Jesus and they reject him. So that doesn't mean that everybody who is drawn to the Son will accept Christ. Many are called, but few are chosen. So all of this is making so much sense. Everything is just falling into place. I have to read the Bible all over again because I feel like I just missed out on like the beauty of it. And that's the thing, it's so beautiful. That's what makes us different. Is the salvation, okay? We don't save ourselves. Otherwise, it wouldn't be called salvation. God saves us. It's all about what he did. It's all about what he's doing. Like, we don't do anything on our own. He made it easy. And you can call it easy believism, but it doesn't seem very easy for a lot of people. That's the thing. The reason why this is so offensive to most people is because it forces you to deny all self-righteousness and all pride. And your flesh wants to be proud. Your flesh wants to march down the street with a flag and say, I'm proud. But you can't do that when you believe on Jesus, because it has nothing to do with you. Nothing. And it's just so amazing. We are called to rest in Christ. He gave us a gift of freedom from trying to be perfect all the time. We don't need to be perfect. We have Him. It's just so amazing. I'm so excited. I want to tell everyone. I want to go out on the streets and tell them Jesus loves you. Jesus loves you. Look what He did for you. Just believe on Him. That's all you have to say. And then Jesus takes over. We're not responsible for changing people. We're responsible for taking people to the one who changes them. Anything other than that is wrong. The beauty of the true gospel is so profound. No one should be deprived of that. No one should be deprived of that. And it brings me back to when I was growing up in church, and I knew that there were believers and there were disbelievers, and the believers were saved and the disbelievers weren't saved. And now we have all of these self-righteous preachers out there saying, repent of your sins and then you're saved. Even though it never says that in the Bible. It never, and I fought this, but it never ever says, repent of your sins to be saved. It says, believe. Then you will repent as time goes on. But it was just so simple when I had it right. And somewhere down the line, I had this transformation. And my flesh wanted to believe that it was from me. No, the Lord did it after I was saved, okay? And I was seeking Him more, so I was becoming mature in Christ, but I wasn't becoming saved. So please don't be deceived. Please don't be deceived. This is so beautiful. It's so easy. It's so much easier to worship the Lord knowing what I know now. Knowing the truth, knowing how easy He made it for us, knowing how beautiful it is and how different it is. Another thing, the Muslims, they repent more than most Christians do, but are they saved? Are they going to heaven? No. Why? Because they don't have faith in Christ and what He did for them. That's why. That's the only thing that's going to save you. Also, this is not to step on any Catholic toes, but the Pope, I do believe, is bad. And he is pushing that you have to have grace and works. That's what they push. That's what every religion pushes, except for Christianity. That's what makes us different and unique, and the truth. If you're relying on your works at all, cut it out now. Because if you stand before the Lord and He asks you, why are you worthy of eternal life? And you start naming things that you've done, you're doomed. You're not going to enter the kingdom of heaven unless you say, well, Lord, you died for my sins, you took my punishment, and you gave me your righteousness, and that's why I should enter the kingdom of heaven, because of what you did, not me. Our righteousness, at best, is filthy rags to the Lord. That's how holy He is. And He's an all or nothing kind of God, which I can deeply respect, because I'm the same way, all or nothing. If it's not perfect, I don't want it. That's how it is. You can't stand before God and enter with your own works, because you would have to be perfect. And even then, you're born in sin. So you're not perfect no matter what you do. So you have to have the Lord's perfection as a covering over you. And I've said all this before, but maybe I need to say it different ways. I don't know. I asked the Lord to talk for me before I made this video, before I hit record. I'm going to put a link down in the description box of this woman who really just spoke it right into me. This woman, she is anointed. She is speaking the truth. She's standing on the truth. She says things in such a way that it's like, whoa, I've never ever thought of it that way. Like, just brilliant. The Lord is so using her. You need to watch her. I watched her for hours last night and this morning. I got up and she was the first thing I thought about besides the Lord. And she was also deceived for many years by Lordship Salvation, so this helped me relate to her. If anything I said led you away from the truth, I am so sorry. All right, I love